NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, presents Aeronautics and Space Report. The distance between Earth and the Sun is 93 million miles. The Sun is the only star we can see in great detail, with energy so massive and powerful it affects everything on or near our planet, from communications and weather to astronauts traveling in space. To study the Sun, NASA has launched a series of orbiting solar observatories, like this most recent one, the 1,200-pound OSO-7. This is OSO Control in Greenbelt, Maryland. It is from here, the Goddard Space Flight Center, that the orbiting solar observatory is commanded and controlled. Goddard coordinates the efforts of some six ground tracking and receiving stations, including ones located in South Africa, Australia, Ecuador, and Chile. These stations receive data from OSO as it passes overhead and then relay it on to Goddard. Here, too, the satellite's electronic pulse is constantly monitored. High-speed printers that can print from 600 to 1,000 words per minute record and digest millions of pieces of data returned by OSO. Example, OSO can store 5,210,000 bits of data in a single orbit of the Earth and then send all of it to a ground station in 5.5 minutes. Scientists would like to map the entire Sun to get a clearer picture of what's going on up there and the causes. One of the ways they do this is with a computerized color display. Hot, active regions on the Sun are indicated by the bright colors. Blacks, purples, and dimmer shades mean that there is less activity. The computer-generated map of the Sun's corona gives scientists a look at the relatively cooler polar caps, and temperature ranges from 900,000 to 72 million degrees. It also tells them the intensity of radiation in a given area. An optical ground-based observatory located at Goddard is pointed toward the Sun. If a disturbance occurs, like a solar flare or solar storm, the OSO spacecraft can be commanded to aim its telescope at the disturbance. Computers, teletype, high-speed printers, data storage, all are information handlers. OSO Control receives, stores, and then passes on the data to scientific experimenters to analyze. Understanding solar physics is indispensable to our understanding the processes that affect Earth and the other planets. Knowledge gained from spacecraft like the orbiting solar observatory may even one day aid physicists in finding an unlimited and pollution-free power source for Earth. NASA has proved the effectiveness of an experimental wing after 27 test flights. Called the Supercritical wing, the new design will have an impact on practically all jet aircraft of the future that fly at the speed of sound, 660 miles per hour. The Supercritical wing was developed through wind tunnel studies by Dr. Richard T. Whitcomb at the Langley Research Center, Virginia. The refashioned wing is flat on top and curved on the underside at the rear. The new shape weakens the shock wave that normally builds on top of conventional wings during flight. The end result? A jet can fly faster without any increase in power and with less fuel. This has been an Aeronautics and Space Report presented by NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. At Goddard is pointed toward the Sun. If a disturbance occurs, like a solar flare or solar storm, the OSO spacecraft can be commanded to aim its telescope at the disturbance. Computers, teletype, high-speed printers, data storage, all are information handlers. OSO Control receives, stores, and then passes on the data to scientific experimenters to analyze. at Goddard is pointed toward the sun. If a disturbance occurs, like a solar flare or solar storm, the OSO spacecraft can be commanded to aim its telescope at the disturbance. Computers, teletype, high-speed printers, data storage, all are information handlers. OSO Control receives, stores, and then passes on the data to scientific experimenters to analyze.